from the World Series, and they go head-to-head with a place at the Olympic Games. Two day up for grabs. What will it mean to either side to get there?
It means everything to each side. That's the thing about a game like this. There is so much riding on it, so much hard work has gone into it. The pressure that they'll feel under, the excitement of the occasion.
Well, Spain's men's team already there. They did the business in Monaco last weekend. Can the women's team make it a double in the qualifiers? Russia might have something to say about that. The pressure they're under to keep this squad together, to keep the coaching ticket together. We'll have the anthems.
Spanish national anthem.
So there we have it, the anthems, both teams obviously fired up and ready to go. I have a feeling, Sude, that the crowd here, bipartisan as they are, might be edging towards Spain, judging by the colours in that stand.
There are definitely more Spanish in the crowd than Russians, that's for sure, and I think the Irish and the Spanish have been making friends today, so I think there'll be a lot of support for the girls in red.
Somehow I think that will only galvanise the Russian team. Hamidova, Petrova, so much experience. Kazakova, Perestiek, and then look at the pace they have to bring off the bench. Thrakova, Shemshuk, Babakova. Incredible lineup for Russia. Sarah Cox, experienced English official in the middle. And for Spain, well, you want to see Patricia Garcia perform today. You want Marina Bravo, the captain, and Vanessa Real. Echevarria equally to bring off the bench. It's a fascinating match. We cannot call this as Lushina gets ready to kickstart the final. 10 minutes aside for the final, as is customary in all sevens tournaments, and first touch for the little pocket rocket from Spain, Patricia Garcia. They got the back from Maria Casado. And Russia early on just having to defend. Finals, 20 minutes long. It's all about fitness at this stage. 2 days of rugby. Both teams flat to the board in the semi-finals to make sure of this place in the final. And what have they got left in the tank? Ball spills out. Spain managed to hang on to it, crucially, and it's taken by Medem. Paula Medem. Foot race on the outside here, taken up by Barbara Platt. She's had a good semi-final, and Platt still going. Platt, you don't see too many red-headed Spanish, but she's in full flight and gets the pass away. Garcia on the right-hand side. This is a wonderful attack by the Spanish. Hamidova drifts across to make the tackle on Vanessa Real. And then Garcia into support. Penalty advantage being played to Spain. None coming.
Barbara Platt channeling her inner Irish is at Hugh. Brilliant, brilliant play from Barbara Platt. She's been so important coming back into this Spanish team, moving the ball from side to side. It's the high tackle, I think, wasn't it?
It was, and Garcia let the referee, Sarah Cox, know exactly how high the tackle was. That's the experience of the Spanish number four, a line out as well, just outside of 22.
Yeah, the Russian defence so far this tournament has rushed up. Nobody's really been able to get through it. Spain, the first team really this weekend to challenge the Russian defence. They've made it all the way from their defensive 22 to the attacking 22. What have they got?
Lineout has to fire here. It does, but it wasn't straight.
It's caught on the outside, not straight.
Rising highest, but the throw from Garcia was not straight. She looks frustrated with that.
Yeah, big groan from the crowd as well. It's always hard playing against this Russian lineout with Hamidova in it, the height that she has. You've got to get your throwing right. It puts more pressure on the thrower.
Trunks. Contrast in teams. I mean, Spain do not have the quickest players.
Set.
They're not slow by any stretch, but they're so aggressive, and line speed and defence is a big part of their game. Turnover ball, that's where they catch teams on the counter-attack. Russia rely on their athletic ability. Lushina dummy the switch and lets the pass out on the outside. Not panicking inside their own 22. The tackle has to go in, and it does from Casado. Bringing
penalty advantage offside.
Yulia Gutseva to the ground. Advantage being played to Russia, offside against Spain. Lushina thinks about the long looping pass. No advantage. We'll go back to the penalty.
Offside, right.
The two defences both putting the opposition under pressure. Spain swarming all over Russia. It's interesting, Barbara Plath playing on the wing for Spain. We haven't seen that for a long time. They moved her inside, but they've decided the jinkiness that she brings, that they're not going to take teams on the outside, but what she does is keep the game alive.
Lushina gets things going once again. Back with the Russian number two, taken by Torestiek, and she can't get past Garcia, but nice pass to keep Kazakova in the game. Hamidova, one outsider, carries it one-handed, beats one, beats two, tries to go past three, almost a hat-trick for the Russian number five, but Russia dropped the ball at a crucial stage with a four-woman overlap.
Yeah, all they had to do was get that ball out. Hamidova had done a really good job of pulling in the Spanish defence. Look, Patricia Garcia, 59 points. Daria Lushina, 54. The top two.
Well, cream rises to the top, doesn't it? And those two, as they stand side by side, the battle of two and four, Trunks. Russia and Spain. That might go a long way to deciding this game.
Set.
Well, that didn't look straight to me. If there was a number eight, that'd be at his feet.
Same tunnel. Okay, reset. Wait.
I mean, just crooked feeds and then does that.
Wait. Yep.
The ref says have another go. Try and get it a little bit straighter this time. Trunks. Interesting to see what Spain do here. They're not going to outpace this Russian midfield.
Set.
And if they can't outrun them, they've got to outthink them.
No, leave out.
Garcia under pressure. Advantage. Didn't touch the ball when Lushina put her hands on her, so penalty advantage to Russia. Barbara Platt takes an awkward one.
Advantage,
I think they've got a shot to nothing here, so why not go for it?
Penalty advantage, high tackle.
Still advantage, this time for a high tackle. Garcia, bit of space in front of her. Pass on the outside to Delpan. Delpan to Medin with the scrum cap over that 10-meter line. A quick ball and recycled ball. This is where Spain can do damage. Lovely hands to Vanessa Real. On the outside is Casado. Casado to Barbara Pla. Pla against Lushina. Pla steps in, and what a tackle to save an almost certain try. Real. Garcia. Keeping that ball alive, but where's it going to bounce? Dangerous stuff.
Right.
Angela Del Pan. Options really on the left-hand side. Patricia Garcia! First try of the game, and it goes to Spain.
Patricia Garcia, if you want it to fall to anybody, that chance, you want it to fall to her. She's always alive to the possibilities around the breakdown. The tackle gets made, but they're still going forward, crucially, Spain. Russia haven't regrouped around the breakdown. Patricia Garcia sees that and powers over, and she'll almost certainly add the extra two. That's what she does so well.
I put the entire house on it. The kids' college fund. This has gone between the posts. She does not miss these ones. 5-0. This is going to be 7. Phew. Kids are going to college. 7-0 Spain, Sue. What a start from them.
What a start from them. They must be thinking the men did it last week. Can we do it this week? What a story that would be. Russia, of course, will have a lot to say about that yet. They need to get the ball in the hands of their power runners, Hamidova, Kazakova, Gutseva.
They just haven't been allowed to play, have they, at the moment?
No, they have not.
Every time they've got the ball, there's been a swarm of red bees around them. And you'd imagine that Pavel Baranovsky, not too happy by the start that his team have made. Hamidova almost lost it. The referee says she did. I didn't see that at all. It looked like she managed to gather that ball.
Yeah, it did. From here, it looked like she caught the ball. You've got to get on with it, though. Whatever the ref says, it goes.
Well, let's see here.
If it touches a player and goes forward from her.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, nothing wrong with that, because it never touched a Spanish player. Unlucky.
Trench. Bind. Set. No, wait.
Garcia feeds the scrum. Lucina again. Just told to leave her alone until she puts her hands on the ball, otherwise it will be a penalty. Vanessa Real trying to go through. Little pop pass, beautiful to keep that alive. Casado, champagne stuff from Spain at the moment. Not afraid to pass the ball in contact. Russia desperate defending. They cannot get their hands on this ball. Just as I say, knock on. And the hands of Cristina Saradina letting her down at a crucial stage.
So near, but yet so far, wasn't it? The accuracy of this Spanish team, the Spanish play in this match, better than anything we've seen all World Series. But there we see it go forward from Saradina. So little possession that Russia have had.
I can tell you, Baranovsky is warming himself up already for the halftime team talk. This ain't going to be pretty.
Trunks!
And it's always what? Spain's tactic to slow set. Matches down because they don't have pace on the pitch. They slow things down. It does not suit Russia.
Nice. Same tunnel, then hooked back in. Okay. Here. Reset.
Ball comes back out the gate. Lucina told to leave her opposite number and allow Garcia to play the ball. And it does come back out. You can put pressure on. You just got to wait until she does that and picks it off the base of the scrum. Garcia straightens the line. Patricia Garcia, foot race for the line. They're not going to catch her. Lucina gives chase, but she knows she's been outsmarted, outrun and outtied by the pocket rocket from Spain.
It is all Spain at the moment, isn't it? Russia really missing their talismanic captain, Kudinova. She would have been a match for Patricia Garcia there. Such a classy player. Takes the defence wide, then steps inside, then powers away. Nothing Russia can do about it. Russia have to start playing at some point.
But they need the ball, don't they? And they just can't get it at the moment. Spain giving a tactical masterclass. They're dominating possession. Garcia to make it 14-0. I'm not going to put anything on this, but you'd be confident just the way she strikes that ball. Bit of a wind coming across from that right-hand side. And, well, look at that. I should have, because that is just brilliant.
Yeah, very, very good from Patricia Garcia. Now, Russia were unlucky, weren't they, at the last kickoff? Can Hamidova get her hands on the ball this time?
Well, 7 tries in the tournament over the last two days for Patricia Garcia. She joins the elite list of 4. One more would see her ahead as we approach the last kickoff of the first half. And what a 10 minutes it's been. And Spain, again, was that knocked on? Advantage, I think, being played to Russia. Hamidova on this near side. They need something before the halftime whistle. Tries the handoff. Any room to get the offload away. She keeps it alive. Now Russia, a rare chance with possession to see what they can do. Ball taken by Bobkova. Bobkova stretching the legs. Bobkova over the halfway line, over the 10, over the 22. Look about that. What a try by Daria Bobkova. And she is going to touch down underneath the post. A lifeline for Russia. They've had no possession. They had no right to score that try. But an individual piece of brilliance from their number 4.
And that is what Bobkova can do to you. Hamidova had a really good hand in it as well, taking the ball all the way wide the other way and getting the offload away. Hats off to Pavel Baranovsky. Bobkova did not start this game. She's crept onto the pitch because she's realised They need to put their gun strike runners on, and she has just creamed them round the outside, Hugh. Brilliant finish.
What a piece of running by Bobkova to finish the half. Underneath the post, brings the gap back to seven with the conversion that goes over from Lushina, and Russia, from being two tries down, now have a gap of just 7 points, and it's thanks to the blonde bombshell, Bobkova, at halftime.
Никто не хочет давить линию. А нам биться надо, чтобы две линии завести. Надо 8 раз войти в контакт, переехать кого-то, а не просто выкинуть мяч на штрафной. Вы начните играть биться, понимаете? Себе адреналин забейте, встань, захвати. Вы же знаете, что Патрисия будет держать, атаковать. Но чего вы впереди падаете?
So, half time, team talks, and the Spanish fans cheering on their team. They're 7 points in front. Interesting, Sue, you've noticed that the Russian captain is in a bit of trouble.
Yeah, she looked very much like she was hobbling as she went into the huddle at half-time and then away from the huddle again. Would explain perhaps why Bobkova came on so early. But Russia, I mean, it's so tough, isn't it? Kudinova at home already, their normal, usual captain, unable to take part in this at all. And now Petrova's hardly played today. If they do get through here, Russia, they'll have been up against it.
Yeah, she didn't start the semi-final against Ireland, Petrova, and curse of the Russian captains at the moment. They're just dropping like flies. Spain don't care, though. They have 10 minutes, rather, to secure their place in the Olympic Games, and they have possession, and the offload slipped underneath to Bravo, the captain. Almost deceived the Russian defence, but penalty for not releasing.
What are Russia doing, though, letting that ball bounce off the kickoff, dropping between about four different players? You have to claim those. Bobkova was the one underneath it. Of course, she's the inexperienced player. Spain so close, so close. Ángela del Pan.
Ball goes on the outside, and Spanish defence struggling to get across. Good tackle goes in. And Bobkova just presents the ball. Bobkova's dropped it, and she's dropped it forward. So it'll be a scrum to Spain. It's that blitz defence again that works out for them.
Yeah, I mean, it's difficult. Bobkova is an inexperienced player. More experience, you'd stop that with your foot, pick it up, don't risk the knock-on in that position. I've been surprised that Russia haven't tried to hit this Spanish scrum. They've got a big old pack, Russia. They're getting really, really good ball from the base of this scrum, Spain, and that's just giving Patricia Garcia all the time the space that she wants. Have a go at this scrum.
And she's taken full advantage with two tries. She's got to work the blind side. The tackle has to go in. Garcia looking for a hat-trick, gets the offload to Pla. Plas over the line, can she get it down though?
You're happy your side? Yeah? Grand and happy? Yeah, try.
Try given! Well, they didn't need to go upstairs. Sue Day, your thoughts on that?
Well, exactly what we were expecting. Good scrum ball, that close to the line. Patricia Garcia is gonna hurt you. They just about managed to bring her down, but Barbara Pla is there, all the experience in the world. Gets the ball down, it's grounded. Spain are playing this tactically brilliantly. Russia have way more power, way more pace out there, but Spain are playing to their strengths.
Russia just look undercooked at the moment. Cannot get anything going. It was a piece of individual brilliance that got them their try. Garcia, two from two. It'll be two from three now. And Barbara Pla, the famous Spanish redhead.
The lack of leadership for Russia is palpable. They don't have the leaders out there that they normally have. They need someone like Kazakova to take this game by the scruff of the neck. She's the one that experienced. At the moment, she's pushed out onto the wing. They need to bring her in a little bit, get her closer to the action.
Plenty of time left. just over 7 minutes to go. And there's an unforced error, the first one by Patricia Garcia.
She has had a brilliant game so far, Patricia Garcia. There's Pavel Baranovsky.
What is he thinking right now?
Who knows what he's thinking? He's thinking, where are my captains?
Russia were flawless yesterday. Lushina, little decoy runner, ball on the outside. Taken by Drakova. One of the top try scorers in Dublin over the weekend. If she gets any space, she's gone. This is Podestiak. Any room for her? Dummy switch in the middle. Floating pass to nobody. And Russian heads are just abandoning them because they're playing kamikaze rugby at the moment.
Yeah, Russia are panicking. There is no need to force that. They simply need to keep possession and move the ball into space. They're trying to score a try with every move. There was no need to play that.
I gathered.
On comes Echeverria.
Slowly.
Slowly. The only time we're going to see her run slowly in this final, though, because she has pace to burn. And she's going to come on to the wing.
Spain is trying to use up as much time as possible.
Crouch.
Really slow the game down. It's worked so well for them.
It's just about, you know, finals are all about how you handle the occasion, aren't they? And they've got advantage here. Russia, discipline, letting them down. The passing letting them down. They cannot get the ball for any sustained period of time. And they are just not handling this final well.
No, they're worrying. They're starting to panic. They're thinking about the result rather than just thinking about the next play and what they need to do. There is plenty of time left. There's nearly a half of a normal sevens game here. There's only two scores in it.
Somebody needs to get that message across to the players, though. Wind up for the pass. Here is the first touch for Echeverria. Beats Drakova, but not at the second attempt. Two players to tackle her. Kazakova eventually puts her on the ground. Ball there to recycle, and Marina Bravo. There for Barbara Plath. And Russia giving away another penalty. This is all eating down the seconds of the clock.
And at the moment, everything's going against Russia. There have been a lot of offsides in this tournament, but they're being noticed now, and poor Russia don't want them to be.
Garcia, dummy switch, and the pass on the left-hand side to Angela Del Pan. It's one outside of Berta Garcia. Berta's got legs into the 22, almost gave the pass, thought better of it, and maybe the wise decision because she has support now to Patricia Garcia. Taken by Bravo, the captain. Barbara Plath has Echeverria outside her. It's got to be a run, and if this pass goes to hand, but it doesn't, and a foot in touch as well, that could have been the winning of the game.
It certainly could have. Unusually poor pass from Barbara Plough. Why are Russia not speeding the game up here, though? Why are they just hanging around waiting for this line out to form? You've got 4 minutes left to score two tries, Russia. Get moving.
No.
Line out over on the 22-meter line. Hamidova, the target here, got a hit. And it's ball off the top for Podestiak to use. Oh, it's mess in Lushina in the midfield. She's lost that ball, gets the penalty. Lushina. Calm heads are needed here. Just try and force a bit of space and give it to the players you know that can do serious damage. Echeverria makes the tackle, recycled. Ball there for Lushina, little chip and chase. Oh, lovely, if this bounces. Oh, beautiful from Lushina. Needs help now and support. Dummy the first pass, then the looping pass on the outside. Surely it must go here, Saradina. Got one outsider, pass goes to Bobkova. Bobkova, surely they won't catch her from there. And she's got to go underneath the post. Bobkova, has she got it down? Just about. And Russia have a lifeline, Sude.
Brilliant from Lushina, brilliant work. Bring the ball back, Bobkova, she's left it behind. They need to get this game moving. The inexperience there, leaving that ball sitting there when you've got a few minutes left in this game. There she goes, Seredina, the final pass out to Bobkova. No one's going to catch her at this point. Great finishing from her, but hurry up, Russia.
Conversion attempt is left and wide. Well, I can tell you that the Irish team has stayed on to watch this final. The Argentinians have as well. And it's great to see the players that are finished with their day's work come out and support the finalists. But Bobkova is off. 7 points the gap, and two tries for the Russian number four, and what a time to do that too.
It's been such a disappointing performance from Russia. Up till now, there's still time, but they just don't look like they believe they can win it. They're looking to each other, who's going to do something, who's going to take the lead? Heads are going down.
This is where Kudanova would be worth her weight in gold.
Exactly right.
Garcia to Bravo. Nice hands from Casado. Keeps that ball alive. Echeverria just takes the tackle. And back for Spain. Pla. Garcia. Two to her right. Pla on the loop around. Nice pass. Oh, look at that. Berta Garcia. Strong hands. And the buff note as well. Del Pan keeps the ball alive. Garcia. Wonderful stuff from Spain. And it's gone forward at a crucial stage. Well, they've 90 seconds, Russia. It's a scrum. It's do or die.
It certainly is. The ball went forward. If Russia could have got their hands on it then, with broken field play.
Well, we know the pace that Drakova has. We know the damage that Kazakova can do as well. But Russia need to get this ball and put those runners into space.
Exactly right. We've seen almost nothing from Kazakova.
Trench.
There is so much Bond. More pace Set. In the Russian team than the Spanish. But the Spanish just closed them down so well.
Lushina. First duty was to win the scrum. That's exactly what they've done in the past. It's another hospital one, taken up well though by Minislamova. Just over a minute to play. Olympic qualification on the line. Russia need a converted try just to draw level and force a golden score. An extra time, Lushina almost looked through the gap. And then the hands desert them. It's not Russia's day, is it? Spain, the men's team qualified last weekend in Monaco. The women have 1 foot in the Olympic Games.
She just had to hold on to that, didn't she? The Spanish defence in disarray. Patricia Garcia, experienced head that she is. I'm injured, I'm down. Slow this game down a bit. That had gone to hand. There was nobody at home.
42 seconds to decide whether or not you go to Rio. What is Jose Antonio Barrio thinking at the moment? He's thinking, for God's sake, hold on.
Well, the Spanish scrum has been really solid, so he'll be feeling pretty confident that. It's so noticeable, the Russian players, though, nobody's speaking to each other, nobody's organising, nobody's coming up with ideas, nobody's saying, this is what we've got to do. Look at all of them, no communication going on there whatsoever.
Russia have the individual athleticism and flair, but the sum of the parts for the Spanish team has been just too strong for this Russian side, as Garcia on a hat-trick, almost at the line. The next score for Spain would kill this one off. 5 metres short now, desperate Russian defence. Ball at the back, Medin. Counter up from the Russians, they give away a penalty, and we've got 10 seconds. Spain, take your time and you're off to Rio.
You can imagine Patricia Garcia again taking her time, the referees letting them take their time. She's going to tap this and kick it to the line.
Garcia boosts the ball into the stand. There's the final whistle, and Spain are going to the Olympic Games. Today, they deserve it 100%.
They deserve it 100% on that performance. We're all surprised. Russia have been the team that has been ahead in the World Series by quite some way. Look at the joy on those Spanish faces. Patricia Garcia, Echeverria, Maria Ribeiro, look at them. Well, they cannot quite believe it, nor can Hamidova. Russia on form should have been the team going to the Olympics. They know it, Spain know it. That's why there is such unbridled joy on the faces of the Spanish. They have played this one so well.
Well, what about that? Russia, when it came to the final, it was like they froze. You can point to a lack of leadership, you can point to poor decision-making on the day, but equally, that would be a disservice to Spain, because they went and took this place at the Olympic Games. It wasn't handed to them, they went out and took it.
Barbara Platt cannot believe it. She's in floods of tears, tears of joy, tears of disbelief almost. There's poor Daria Lushina. Russia's so disappointed. The sport is so cruel, isn't it? The joy that Spain are feeling equaled by the despair of the Russians.
Well, the men did it last weekend in dramatic